This is the SAP Developer News for May the 22nd, 2025, Special Sapphire Edition.
Hey everybody, Josh Bentley, Mr. Bluebeard, and representing the SAP Experience Center here on the Sapphire show floor. Now what we've got is you come in and you learn about the different roles that you can do. You can be a CIO, CFO, different personas associated with all the technology SAP is talking about here at Sapphire. And once you do that, we create an AirTag that works with an Android or an iOS phone. It gets custom built here and attached to your device. So when you go home, you can continue learning what you were actually exploring here on the show floor. And if we go this way, we've got the newest member of the SAP community. I want to show him to you. He's AI powered by Jewel, I'm sure. Nice little robot there, Android. And we got things going on with tons of business transformation, AI, supply chain. Over here, we have an injection machine showing you how you can actually print the parts that were shown in the keynote. And then this is how they come from the machine. If it breaks, you get the repair part actually from the warehouse. So it's all automated and it's a great demo for all the customers here. This is just one section of the Sapphire show floor. I'm going to sneak out now the back and skip part of the experience center and go towards the learning and certification hub where everybody can actually go through and they can learn and take some tests on site and see what the certification programs are like. On the way to that, which is way back in the corner, you can stop by any of the vendor booths that are happening. And you've got plenty of vendors that we've known for years that are great trusted partners and customers. And then we've got in the middle, all the applications, BTP, all the sections that you can go to for, let's say, a different theater session. I was talking to Sonia Leonard earlier, and her team is doing great things with ABAP Cloud. And so much is coming with that and AI and the innovations that we're doing in that space. So again, it's super busy here, Sapphire. This is the end of day three coming up. And what I want to get out of this is that you've got a ton of energy here in the community. And a lot of things going on for not just developers, for everybody at SAP, but I'm heading back there to do some more work in the SAP Learning and Certification Hub. I'll talk to you later. Bye.
Hello, everybody. It's an immense pleasure to bring you all the crucial highlights from SAP Sapphire 2025 annual conference that happened over the last 2 days in Orlando, Florida. Let's get this thing right off the bat. Jewel Studio has been launched as part of SAP Build Solution portfolio. Jewel Studio has two key capabilities. Number one, Skill Builder capability. Using this, you can design custom skills and execute predefined tasks within conversations, triggered contextually by user intent. These skills produce specific results. They are configurable to the customer landscape. Skills can leverage other build components such as pre-built automations, access to third-party integrations, and AI models. This feature will be made available by end of Q2 this year. Number two, Agent Builder capability. Using this, you can create custom AI agents that can execute processes and workflows with varying adaptability and self-healing capabilities. Rather than following a set of prescribed instructions, agents leverage the thinking capability aspect of LLM to figure out how to solve a problem, as well as APIs to augment their solution. Grounded in customer business data and SAP knowledge graph, these agents can deliver precise outputs and business-centric outcomes, accommodating human inputs throughout the workflow. This feature will be made available Q4 this year. If you would like to know more details about Jewel Studio, do read this blog post by SAP BTP expert Bharat Sandhu. Link is in the description box. That's not it. SAP announces new Jewel capabilities for developers in SAP Build. These AI-assisted capabilities help empower developers at any skill level to build applications more quickly and easily. Number one, SAP Build Work Zone. Employees can work smarter with quick access provided by Jewel to relevant apps, tasks, and processes from one central place. Users can further use Jewel to query documents using document grounding capabilities, create new documents, and summarize them for relevant information needs. by providing AI responses based on SAP relevant data from SAP Build Workzone, employees can save time and stay productive. Number two, in SAP ABAP Cloud, whether it's migrating custom ABAP ECC code to SAP Cloud ERP to maintain a clean core or adapting existing legacy code to ABAP Cloud model standards, these AI-driven enhancements can help developers be more productive and deliver precise outcomes faster. These two capabilities will be made available in Q3 this year. If you need more details, kindly refer to the BTP Innovation Guide provided in the description. Keep exploring and keep learning. Thank you.
There's a new online resource for folks in the SAP tech ecosphere, and that is the SAP Architecture Center. Think of it as a one-stop shop for reference architectures on topics as diverse as event-driven application design, multi-region resiliency, federated machine learning, and lots more. Why are reference architectures so important? Well, think best practices, think standardization, scalability, efficiency, and interoperability. And the best part about the new SAP Architecture Center? It's open for collaboration, for feedback and contributions, using effectively the industry standard for collaboration on documentation, and that is via GitHub. I've already made my first contribution. Dive in to the SAP Architecture Center now. See you online.
Beyond the exciting AI advancements announced at Sapphire, SAP Build is bringing a host of expanded capabilities to help customers seamlessly extend their SAP Business Suite. Let's look at what they are. An enhanced Build Lobby, which acts as the central hub for creating extension projects, is now generally available, which makes it easier than ever to get started. Extensibility Wizard, a guided tool which simplifies the process of building on-stack and side-by-side extensions, was made available in S/4HANA Public Cloud Edition at the end of last year. And here is more good news. By second half of 2025, this capability will also be available for SuccessFactors solutions. Data products from SAP Business Data Cloud will be accessible directly within SAP Build, supercharging application development while giving users richer data insights. This transformative integration is set to go live in second half of 2025. SAP Build will soon support a wider range of event sources, enabling real-time dynamic interactions across multiple systems. Expect this feature to become generally available in the second half of 2025. SAP Build's streamlined pricing lets customers extend their business suite while giving developers the flexibility to choose the right tools without the hassle of managing multiple licenses. With these powerful new capabilities, SAP Build is set to transform how businesses create and scale extensions.
We've already heard from some of my colleagues about other AI enhancements that were announced at Sapphire this week, those affecting BTP, the integration suite, how Joule Studio is being introduced inside of SAP Build for extending Joule capabilities, as well as how the Business Data Cloud is the foundation of bringing business data into AI and making it more intelligent. But I'd like to talk to you now about some of the announcements that came that were part of the AI foundational layer. And right there, there was an announcement of a new version, new capabilities for AI Foundation itself. We see the current capabilities of AI Core and AI Launchpad being enhanced with new features like a new agent runtime. Or another example is the prompt optimizer to help you both optimize your existing prompts, but also help you write LLM independent prompts so that you're no longer tied with your prompts and your LLM generation overall to a particular LLM. And that's through a partnership with Diamond AI. We'll be bringing the prompt optimizer to the BTP AI experience. We also saw another important partnership, and that's with Perplexity. This is a tool that gives you an LLM-like experience, but searching current information in the web. It's also really good at citing its sources and providing those in the output. And this is an experience that we plan to bring to SAP Joule in the near future as well. So that was two super exciting partnerships that are going to enhance the AI capabilities of Joule and what you can build with AI on SAP BTP. And finally, we also saw the impact that the WalkMe acquisition is having to tie together Joule capabilities across your entire business, whether that's the SAP business suite or non-SAP capabilities as well. There's some really cool demos showing how ServiceNow was integrated with Ariba and S4. And Joule was able to tie that all together through the WalkMe capabilities. And like we said the other day in our little write-up after the day one keynote, this gives you a glimpse of some of the great things that are going to come to Sapphire, to TechEd later this year. Because the announcements you hear at Sapphire are often the things we'll be able to show you exactly how you as developers are going to use later this year at TechEd. So be on the lookout for all that kind of information coming later this year.